Secretary Clinton, Mr. Trump, welcome. Let's get right to it. There is almost no issue that separates the two of you more than the issue of immigration. Actually, there are a lot of issues that separate the two of you. The question really is, why are you right and your opponent wrong? Mr. Trump, you go first in this segment. You have 2 minutes. Mr. Trump, thank you. Same question to you, Secretary Clinton.
The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, cry. I watch them grow. They learn much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
We're going to get them out. We're going to secure the border. And once the border is secured, at a later date, we'll make a determination as to the rest. But we have some bad hombres here, and we're going to get them out.
Hold on, folks. Because this is going to end up getting out of control. I have to ask some questions.
Yes,
and I would like to ask you this direct question. The top national security officials of this country do believe that Russia has been behind these hacks. Even if you don't know for sure whether they are, do you condemn any interference by Russia in the American election? Is fitness to be president of the United States. Mr. Trump, at the last debate, you said your talk about grabbing women was just that, talk.
I don't give a damn about my reputation.
Nine women have come forward and said that you either groped them or kissed them without their consent. Why would so many different women from so many different circumstances over so many different years, why would they all in this last couple of weeks make up, you deny this, why would they all make up these stories?
She was afraid to come out of the locker. She was as nervous as she could be. She was afraid to come out.
I will tell you, what isn't fictionalized are her emails, where she destroyed 33,000 emails.
It's hard for me to say I'm sorry. After all that we've been through, I will make it up to you. I promise to.
People talking about me, baby. I'm doing you wrong, doing you wrong. Well, don't you worry, baby, don't worry. Cause I'm right here, right here, right here, right here at home. Cause I'm a picker, I'm a grinner, I'm a lover, and I'm a sinner. I play my music in the sun.
smoker, I'm a smoker, I'm a midnight toker. I give my loving on the run.
I'll just use what the good Lord gave me. So don't call me honey, and don't call me baby. Don't call me baby.
From everything I see, has no respect for this person.
Well, that's because he'd rather have a puppet as president of the United States.
No puppet.
And it's pretty clear.
You're the puppet.
It's pretty clear you won't admit
that the
Russians.
I got no strings to hold me down, to make me red or make me brown. I had strings, but now I'm free. There are no strings on me.
As the final question in the final debate, to tell the American people why they should elect you to be the next president. This is another new mini segment. Secretary Clinton, it's your turn to go first. Secretary Clinton, thank you. Mr. Trump.
Well, we're living here in
both. Secretary Clinton, hold on just a moment, folks. Secretary Clinton, Mr. Trump, I want to thank you both for participating in all three of these debates. That brings to an end this year's debate sponsored by the Commission on Presidential Debates. We want to thank the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, and its students for having us. Now the decision is up to you. While millions have already voted, Election Day, November 8th, is just 20 days away. One thing everyone here can agree on, we hope you will go vote. It is one of the honors and obligations of living in this great country. Thank you and good night.